Hello and welcome to Monmouth in Focus, a program about the services and functions of Monmouth County government. I'm Cynthia Scott, your host for this segment of Monmouth in Focus. Monmouth County has lots of great things to do and see, and one of our local treasures is the Monmouth Museum, located on the campus of Brookdale Community College. To tell us about the museum and its upcoming exhibits is Julia Fiorino. Julia, thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
What makes the Monmouth Museum so unique?
The Monmouth Museum was founded as a museum of ideas instead of a collecting museum. And our mission is to engage audiences with inspiring ideas presented through imaginative and informative exhibitions and educational programs.
What can visitors expect to see then once they walk into a museum? It's probably a different experience for them.
Yes, we have two main galleries as well as two children's wings. And in our main galleries, we feature changing exhibitions on art, history, science, and culture.
Mm-hmm. And then the children's wing is the Becker Children's Wing?
That's right. The Becker Children's Wing and the Wonder Wing both are designed as comfortable learning environments with hands-on interactive exhibitions. Mm-hmm. In the Becker Children's Wing, exhibitions are usually mounted for a two to three year duration, and our Wonder Wing is a permanent exhibition.
And what do they have in the Becker Children's Wing now?
In the Becker Children's Wing, we're currently featuring an exhibition called Changing Climate, Changing Weather. Mm-hmm. And this explores the history and science of climate and weather. Visitors can explore different types of weather through a variety of sensory displays. They can be a weather person on our virtual weather TV station. They can make a craft in our green arts studio.
Wow.
And many additional activities.
So schools come to visit the weather. Right now you have the weather, and that's 2 years, right? So the school,
yes,
elementary schools or middle schools will come and visit the scene and really get a hands-on interactive experience that they probably can't get out of a textbook when they learn about weather, correct?
Absolutely. We provide school tours, also scout groups, and other groups visit on a regular basis. The exhibitions are designed in conjunction with school curriculum topics.
Mm-hmm.
And in the past, we've featured Western migration, energy, the human body, space exploration.
Sure.
So we really, really explore a wide range of topics.
So is that how you decide what the topic's going to be?
Yes. We do work in conjunction with teachers and in developing those exhibitions.
But a lot of research must go on. And how did you research the weather topic and really, you know, put this whole presentation together?
Absolutely. We felt that it was a very relevant
Sure.
topic today to explore climate change and also provide an opportunity for our visitors to learn about protecting the environment and reducing, reusing, and recycling.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And you also have a part of the children's wing that's always there. What is that?
Yes, our Dorothy V. Morehouse Wonder Wing is also a hands-on interactive exhibition. It's a permanent exhibition that is based on the sea and the creatures that make it, their home there. Children can explore a pirate ship and climb into a lighthouse. They
wow.
can slide through
well,
a whale and do a craft.
Uh-huh. Now, and they last for 2 years, the weather, their ever-changing climate. Those
That's
are
correct.
The ones that last for 2 years
mm-hmm.
in the children's wing. The other
is
one
permanent.
Is always there. The hours of operation?
Yes. The museum is open Tuesday through Sunday. We're closed on Mondays. And we're open 10 to 4:30 Tuesday through Saturdays, 1 to 5 on Sundays. However, I would advise our visitors to call ahead
okay.
For the Becker Children's Wing and the Wonder Wing. The hours do change because of our visiting school groups.
Right. And how about the galleries at the museum?
Yes, the galleries in our main gallery, we feature changing exhibitions. We featured both internationally known artists such as George Siegel and Robert Rauschenberg.
Mm.
We have traveling exhibitions from the Smithsonian Institution as well as other museums. And we also feature juried exhibitions. exhibitions on a regular basis on a variety of wonderful topics, including art from recycled objects, art on paper, fiber arts.
So there must be, is there a research department at the museum that decides what exhibit we're going to have, in the gallery?
And, yes, and we have an exhibition committee, mm-hmm. Who's responsible for that. And I'd like to also mention that in our smaller gallery, in our Nielsen Gallery, we feature the New Jersey Emerging Artist Series.
Right.
We're in its fifth year, and we welcome artists to submit their work. We select six artists each year that are provided with a solo exhibition, and it's a really wonderful opportunity for them to show their work and present gallery talks as well.
And to highlight some of the most talented artists within our state.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. And how about the programs to supplement the exhibits?
We offer a wide variety of educational programs, gallery talks, tours, visits to other cultural institutions, as well as activities on a regular basis.
Mm-hmm. Now, there are many museums that rely on volunteers to help get some of that work done. Is that the case with Monmouth as well?
We have a very dedicated group of volunteers that donate their time and creative talents in a variety of areas at the museum. We have a group of retired gentlemen who we call our A-team, who come in once a week. We also have the Friends of the Monmouth Museum, a very social and volunteer group that helps us with our programs, special events, and fundraisers. And we welcome new volunteers. We encourage you to contact the museum, to call us, or visit our website for more details.
And how did the museum begin?
The museum was established in 1963 as the result of a needs assessment conducted by the Junior League of Monmouth County. It was determined that there was a need for a cultural center, an arts and cultural center in the community. For the first 10 years, they held temporary exhibitions in temporary spaces throughout eastern Monmouth County.
Sure.
And in 1974... we moved into our permanent home here on the Brookdale Community College campus.
Mm-hmm. Let's go back to the weather exhibit. What's the reaction that you see from children?
Children are delighted, and you can just see and hear and also hear their comments.
Right.
The opportunity to experience the exhibition in a hands-on way is so important to them to augment their in-class learning.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And how about for some of the other exhibits in the past? I know that you said you did an exhibit on the human body. You know, it's something that children, to me, when it comes to these types of exhibits, specifically for children, they just can't. It's hard to grasp out of a book, but when they see it and when they are able to touch it and really get an idea as to how things work, it all comes together, right?
Yes, and these exhibitions are really a lot of fun,
yeah,
too,
mm-hmm.
To explore. And we also offer after-school activities that now feature a scavenger hunt. You can create a craft in the Green Arts Studio, watch a movie in our amphitheater, and see a planetarium show.
Wow. Are those done by groups or can an individual come in
those
as
are
well?
Open. Those are open to the public.
Okay.
During the week.
Mm-hmm. And again, the hours of operation at Brookdale Museum is...
Yes. Our regular hours are Tuesday through Saturday from 10 to 4:30, mm-hmm. and Sundays from 1 to 5.
Okay. And then, of course, obviously, there's so many school groups, so many tours that come throughout the year to call in advance as well. Is this your first experience working in a museum? I know you said you've been there for about 6 years.
That's correct.
Is this your first experience working in a museum?
It is. Mm-hmm. I have previously worked at a historical society, but this is my first. I've always loved museums and visited them since I was very small. And some of my most memorable experiences were exploring museums. So I'm delighted to have the opportunity to now work at the Monmouth Museum.
In a sense, it's almost like a dream come true.
That's right. Right.
And really, and for the people that you work with, you all share such a, I mean, if you want to work in a museum, you really do have to have that interest. Like you said, you grew up going to museums, loving museums. And I remember, too, growing up, you know, it was a special day for us to go to the museum, whether it was in Manhattan or whether it was our local museum that we lived close to.
Yes, and I just want everyone to know that this museum is your community museum.
Sure.
We offer something for all interests, and I invite you to visit and explore all of our offerings.
You know, it is a community museum. It's the Monmouth County Museum, but really there is so much to offer there for kids of different ages, for adults to look at the galleries, to view the exhibits. There really is a lot of information there, and it's a good day. It would be a good way to spend a Saturday, whether the sun was shining or it was raining, right?
Absolutely.
All right, Julia, thanks so much for joining us today, for sharing that information, and we look forward to seeing you in the future.
Thank you.
That is all the time we have for this segment of Monmouth in Focus. For more information about the Monmouth Museum, you can log on to www.visitmonmouth.com. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Cynthia Scott. Have a great day, everyone.